Hi, and welcome to the next module of the PowerMux Deep Dive, titled Choosing the Right PowerMux Device. In the previous modules, we've discussed what TI PowerMuxes have to offer. These are things to consider when choosing the right PowerMux. First, is automatic or manual switchover required? Is priority or an ORing configuration needed? Lastly, what system protections are needed? Using the link here, you can search through TI's PowerMux portfolio, which I will describe in further detail in the next slides. Let's begin with our low voltage PowerMuxes with adjustable current limits. Among these, the TPS2115A is going to have a faster switchover time versus the TPS211X family due to the differences in propagation delays. Please refer to the switching section in the datasheet for more specific details. Now, the D package shown on the right is available for both the TPS2113A and TPS2115A devices. This is a QFN package capable of limiting up to 2 amps. Located in the datasheet are tables such as this, which provide in further detail what switching modes, current limit ranges, and status outputs are available for each generic part number within the TPS211X and TPS211XA families. Moving forward to our new portfolio for low voltage applications, we do not currently offer output current limiting. Therefore, if current limiting is not needed, the TPS2116 or TPS2117 would be the better option in terms of availability and resources for low voltage applications due to its new release. The TPS2116 and TPS2117 also have a higher continuous current rating, lower R-on, and smaller size with our newest technology. One distinction between the product definition between the 211X and TPS2116 families is that we specify a transition time for the 211XX devices. This is noted as TT, which measures the rise time during switchover. Moving forward in our new devices, we instead specify what we refer to as the switchover time. Since these PowerMuxes work in a break before make configuration, as discussed in the earlier modules, there is a point where no voltage is delivered to the load. The switchover time, TSW, measures the time that no voltage is delivered to the output. The TPS2116 and TPS2117 devices offer a fast switchover highlighted to ensure downstream loads do not experience a loss of voltage below their undervoltage thresholds. This is noted here and highlighted. When the device determines it is time for a switchover, the output will only be disconnected from the input for the switchover time. In the case of the 2116, this is 8 microseconds typical. Taking a closer look at the TPS2117, we can see what features the device offers. For more information on designing for the schematic for this device, please refer to the next module and the design calculator listed below. For higher voltage applications, we have a greater feature set, including overvoltage protection, adjustable current limit, soft start time control, and thermal shutdown. These features are discussed in further detail in the previous section of this video series. Now, when choosing between these options, do note that the maximum continuous current rating increases from left to right. Another important distinction is the package. With the TPS2124 and the TPS2120 using a 20-pin WCSP package. Now, this offers a smaller size. However, it does increase the design complexity, especially during layout. Now, this table details the recommended devices for each power muxing application described in the first video of this series for high voltage applications. Now, for manual switchover or automatic ORing, any of these devices can be used. But for automatic switchover with priority, please use the TPS2121. Taking a closer look at the TPS2121, we can see what features the device offers, which are described in further detail in the previous video module. For more information on designing the schematic for this device, please also refer to the next module and the design calculator link below. For more information on power muxes, please visit the link above. And for more information on the power switch portfolio, please check the following links and the collateral listed. Specifically, the 11 ways to protect your power path, which will assist you in your next power design.